Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our General Assembly. It's Friday, thank God it's Friday, March 19, 2021. Sorry for the late start for devotion this morning, but delay does not mean denial. So I want to use the opportunity to start to get into the frame of mind for worship, start to reflect on God's goodness on our life, and just see how far we have reached as a school family as we continue to learn during COVID-19. But before we start, you know, as usual, we'll start with our song, you know, just to get into the frame of mind to wake up. So let's get ready. Of time, I can't wake you up anymore. So I have Lillian Bernard Minot here with us this morning. Lillian is no stranger to Fernport High School. She's a past student of this institution. She served as head girl, right, and served on the sixth form association. She's also one of the first batch of our sixth form when we started early in 2015. So no stranger to all. She's currently one of our lab technicians helping out in the science department. And she's here to share the word with you this morning. So get ready. You know that she always filled with the Holy Spirit. So help me welcome Lillian Bernard Minot to share the word this morning. Ms. Gentles, you still can hear me, right? Just doing a test, we'll call it mic check. Mr. Gordon, are you hearing me?
Hearing you loud and clear, sir.
All right, good, good. All right.
Yes, sir.
Good, good. Thank you. Good, good.
Good morning, Frankfort High School. It is indeed a privilege this morning to be sharing with you. As Mr. Thomas said, I'm no stranger. I'm a past student, and I'm also currently working here as a lab technician. Now, I have been seeking the Lord for a word to encourage the Frankfort High School family. And the Lord began to speak to me, and he says to me, the young people of our today's generation, they are struggling with self-identity, not knowing who they are. And so this morning, I want to bring to you the topic of self-identity. Now, when we speak about identity, we speak about having a self-worth, a sense of self-worth that makes you feel confidence about you, that makes you feel confidence about yourself. Now, there are three dimensions to self-identity. The first one is knowing who you are. The second one is knowing whose you are. And the third one is knowing what you are about. Once you have mastered these three dimensions of self-identity, then you are on your way to success. You are on your way to receive mind-blowing experiences. And so the first dimension, it speaks of knowing who you are. Now, as a student, as a teacher, as a parent, whoever you may be, it is important to know who you are. Now we are in a world, in a society where everybody is trying to be like somebody. We are in a society where the world actually paved an identity for us instead of actually thinking and reflecting about who and whom God says we are. And so in the first dimension of knowing who you are, it is important to know and to reflect on the promises of God that speaks about who you are. In the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 13, the Bible speaks of who you are. You are the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath. And so you have to know, you have to believe those promises. You have to believe in those words that God says you are. And so in going forward, knowing who you are, it is important for you not to take on the world's identity, not to take on what the world says you are, but believe in whom God says you are. The second dimension I want to share with you is about knowing whose you are. You are God's masterpiece. He created you in his own likeness. He created you in his own image. And so it is important to know whose you are. You are of God. And so in this society, in today's world, so many young people, they are struggling with identifying who they really are. And that is why you have a lot of skin bleaching going on. And the Lord has also revealed to me that self-identity, the identity crisis that is going on today, it has caused a lot of young people to turn to violence. And that is why a lot of crime is taking place in our today's world, because persons are trying to figure out who they are. And this message not only go for students, but it also go for adults. Because even in today's society, we have adults who are still trying to figure out who they really are. And because they don't know who they are, they take on the personality of others. They try to imitate others. They try to be like others. So it is very important to know that you are God's masterpiece. He has created you in his own likeness and his own image. The last dimension is knowing what you are about. Now, that dimension speaks of your assignment, your purpose, your God's given purpose, what God has called you to do. In the book of Esther, chapter 3, Mordecai says to Esther, not only do you have a purpose, but you also have an assignment. And it's important to know that as human beings, we were created to do something. We all have an assignment. We all have a purpose and an assignment attached to our name. And that is why it is important for us to know God. It is important for us to study about him. It is important for us to reflect on his will, his promises for our lives, so that we can go forth and we can be who God truly has called us to be. And even now, as I am speaking, there is a division that is taking place between the spiritual and the physical, because it is important to know that the physical, the mind is not physical, but it's spiritual. And whatsoever you say you are, that's what you are. Before anything can happen, it has to first take place in the mind. And God has shown me where the mind, it is very important, and it relates directly to your destiny. And let me tell you how this relates now. When you think, the first thing that takes place in your mind. So your mind is a set of information that garners your thoughts. Your thoughts dictates to how you think. Your thoughts, then it forms your actions. So whatever your thoughts are, then you start to act like that. Your actions then become your habits. And your habits become your character. Your character then becomes your lifestyle. And your lifestyle becomes your destiny. It shapes your destiny. And it's also important to know, by virtue of your lifestyle shaping your destiny, it is important to know that your destiny is equivalent to a sum total of decisions that you have made yesterday. And so it is important to know that the mind is a spiritual place and not physical. And so the more you reflect on the word of God, the more you know God, the more you study about him, the more you pray, is the more he reveals his will unto you. And so you know how to live. You know how to grow. You know you can identify yourself as an individual. And so the last 2 points I'm going to share with you before I pray. There are 2 factors that actually contributes, or I should say, it breaks someone's identity. And the first one is comparison. Comparison. So the toxic art of comparison, when you constantly compare yourself to others, it actually robs you of your blessing. Because most time persons compare themselves when it relates to strength versus weakness. So comparison, it robs you of your blessing. The second thing that it does, it erodes your self-confidence. And it erodes the fact of you thinking positively about yourself. The third thing that it does, it fuels your insecurities and it fuels your low self-esteem. And the fourth thing that comparison does, it damages you spiritually and leaves you discouraged. So never you compare yourself to others. Always know that you are fearfully, you're wonderfully made. You are above and not beneath. You are a royal priesthood. You are a peculiar people. And the sooner persons identify and know who they are, then we are on our way to mind-blowing experiences. Good success can only be attained when you know and recognize who you really are. The second factor is impersonation. A lot of persons have tried to draw on the character of someone else's. And so by virtue of you doing that, you degrade yourself and then you elevate someone else, thinking that you're not this and you are not that. And so you take on the personality of someone else, trying to be like someone. And because of that, it leaves you in a state where you have a low self-esteem and you think very low about yourself. But it's not time for us to think about others. It's not time for us to undermine ourselves and compare or impersonate others. but reflect on who God says you are. Reflect on his promises, know his will concerning your life. And I can assure you that you will be on your way to good success and mind-blowing experiences. Glory to the name of Jesus. And even now, I'm just going to pray for someone. So just bow your heads with me while I pray. Glory to the name of Jesus. Father, we honor you. We lift you up. We praise you. We thank you that you are God. You are all powerful. You are omnipotent. You are mighty. There is none like unto you, Jehovah. There is none to compare to you. There is none to match up to you, mighty God. And Father, as we come in your presence this morning, we thank you that you are the all-knowing God. You are the all-sufficient God. Father, in you we move. In you we trust. In you we have our being. And God, as Almighty, as I stand in the gap, O God, of the Franklin family this morning, as you have revealed, O Lord God, that they are struggling with, O God, an identity crisis. They are struggling to find out who they really are in you. And so, God, they are taking on the personality and the identity of the world. Father, even now we bring, O God, all those concerns before you this morning. And we ask, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you will lead and you will direct, O God, your people. Father God, we pray in the name of Jesus that your will for their life, O God, it shall come to pass. Your will for their life, O God, it shall be fulfilled. Mighty God, we come against fake identity. We bind the spirit of stigma. We bind, O God Almighty, superficiality. We bind, O God Almighty, Father, stigmatization. And even now, we release an excellent spirit, O God, upon your people. The spirit of Daniel, the spirit of governance, the spirit, O God, of excellence, the spirit, O God, of right standing with you. Mighty God, even now we release, O God, the supernatural anointing, even now. And God, even now, as I am praying, Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you'll help, O God, your children to recognize who they really are in you. Help them, O God, to recognize their God-given purposes. Help them, O God, to realize that you, O God, have called them to be what you say they really are. They are the head and not the tail. They are above and not beneath. They are a royal priesthood. Mighty God, we want to thank you for the identity that you have given unto them. And God, even now, Father, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you'll meet them on the way. Lord God, whatsoever concerns they have, O God, concerning their lives, concerning their destinies that they are not sure about, we pray that your divine will be done in their lives and your divine will be revealed unto them even now. We bind the spirit of suicide. We bind the spirit of low self-esteem. We bind the spirit of, oh God Almighty, discouragement. And we release the spirit of positivity. We release the spirit, oh God, of high self-esteem and confidence upon your people even now. Father, we pray that they will have a self of identity and a self of recognition in you. Father, today, touch someone's heart. Touch their mind, touch their spirit, touch their entire being. We pray even now, God, that they will have an encounter with you today, an encounter, God, that they will never forget. And Father, as they progress through the rest of this week and even, oh God, to the upcoming week, I pray, God, that you will start a good work in them. And that work, oh God, will reflect who you truly are to them and what they truly are in you. And God, even now, remember their parents. Remember, oh God, the teachers. Remember, God, the staff of the Franklin High School. We entrust them in your hands this morning and in your care. And Father, we pray, God, even as we go through these trying times, as we go through these last and closing days, Father, we will reflect on your goodness. We will reflect, oh God Almighty, on your positivity. We will reflect, oh God, on the will that you have concerning our lives. And Father, even now, we thank you for the identity that you have given unto them. And we thank you, God, that they are now knowing who they are, whose they are, and what they are about. We give you all the honor this morning, all the praise, and all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. It is well. I trust and hope that your hearts have been blessed. Your spirit has been blessed. And going forward, you will no longer take on the identity of the world, but you will now know who you are, whose you are, and what you're about. Have a blessed day and a wonderful day.
Amen. 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 Thank you, Lillian, for sharing the word with us this morning. Remember, we must believe who we are in Christ. We must not take on the identity of the world, but must take on what God has put in each of us, what we are expected, using our gifts and talents, and ensure that we are always putting forward the spirit of excellence. Thank you again. All right, colleagues and students online, it's now 8:31. We are in the first session of the day, so I cannot go any further. But join me Monday morning at the same time, 8 o'clock, where I have another guest speaker who will share the word with you. Have a wonderful day, a wonderful weekend, and make sure you follow the COVID-19 protocol and stay safe. Have a good day, everyone.